In this video, we're continuing on with the dividing polynomials worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 7. We have r squared plus 14r plus 38 divided by r plus 8. We'll start by looking at r. We need to see how many times r goes into r squared. R times r will give us r squared. So then we're going to take that r value and multiply it by r plus 8. R times r plus 8 will get subtracted from r squared plus 14r plus 38. So r times r plus 8 is r squared plus 8r. Subtracting that, we'll get r squared minus r squared, which is 0, plus 14r minus 8r is 6r, and that is added to 38. Now we need to see how many times that r goes into 6r. R goes into 6r a positive 6 times. So we're adding 6 to the r in our answer. Now we're going to multiply 6 by r plus 8. 6 times r plus 8 is 6r plus 48. And we're subtracting that quantity. So 6r minus 6r is 0, 38 minus 48 is a negative 10. So our remainder is negative 10. Our answer, r plus 6, with a remainder of negative 10. When we write that, we'll write r plus 6 minus, since our remainder is negative, 10 over what we divided by, r plus 8. And that is our solution in number 7. R plus 6 minus 10 over r plus 8. For number 8, we're dividing x squared plus 5x plus 3 by x plus 6. X goes into x squared x times. So now we're going to multiply x by x plus 6. X times x plus 6 is x squared plus 6x, and we're subtracting that quantity. X squared minus x squared is 0, 5x minus 6x is negative 1x, and we're still adding 3. X goes into negative 1x negative 1 times, so we're subtracting 1 from the x in our answer. Now we're going to multiply negative 1 by x plus 6. Negative 1 times x plus 6 is going to be negative x minus 6, and that is subtracted. So negative 1x minus a negative x, or minus a negative 1x, is 0, and then 3 minus a negative 6 is 3 plus 6, which is a positive 9. So our remainder is 9. Now we'll write out our answer. X minus 1 with a remainder of 9 will be x minus 1 plus, since our remainder is positive, 9 over x plus 6. So x minus 1 plus 9 over x plus 6 is our solution in number 8. In number 9, we have 2x squared minus 17x minus 38, and we're dividing that polynomial by the binomial 2x plus 3. So 2x squared minus 17x minus 38 divided by 2x plus 3. First, we're going to see how many times 2x goes into 2x squared, and that's x times. X times 2x is 2x squared. So we're going to take that x and multiply it by 2x plus 3. X times 2x plus 3 is 2x squared plus 3x. So subtracting that, we'll get 2x squared minus 2x squared, which is 0. Negative 17x minus 3x is negative 20x, and we're still subtracting 38. Now we're going to see how many times 2x goes into negative 20x, and that's negative 10 times, so minus 10 from that x. Now we're going to multiply negative 10 by 2x plus 3. Negative 10 times 2x plus 3 is negative 20x minus 30, and that is subtracted. So negative 20x minus negative 20x is 0. Negative 38 minus negative 30 is negative 38 plus 30, which is a negative 8. So our remainder is negative 8. So our solution is x minus 10 minus, since our remainder is negative, 8 over 2x plus 3. X minus 10 minus 8 over 2x plus 3. And number 10, we're taking 42x squared minus 33 and dividing that by 7x plus 7. However, note, we're missing that x to the first term. So we're going to write 42x squared plus 0 times x, or 0x, minus 33. And we're doing that as a placeholder. So it's not changing the value of this original polynomial. It's still 42x squared minus 33, since 0x is 0. And we're dividing that by 7x plus 7. So we're going to see how many times does 7x go into 42x squared? And that's 6x. So we're going to take that 6x and multiply it by 7x plus 7. So we'll get our 42x squared, and then 6x times 7 is 42x, and this is subtracted. So 42x squared minus 42x squared is 0. 0x minus 42x is negative 42x, and we're subtracting that 33. Now we're going to see how many times 7x goes into negative 42x, and that's negative 6 times, so we're subtracting 6. Now we'll take that negative 6 and multiply that by 7x plus 7. That'll be negative 42x minus 42. And that is subtracted. So negative 42x minus a negative 42x is 0. Negative 33 minus a negative 42 is a positive 9. So we have 6x minus 6 with a remainder of 9. So now when we write our solution, we'll write it as 6x minus 6 plus, since our remainder is positive, 9 over what we divided by, 7x plus 7. And that's our solution in number 10. In number 11, again, we're going to add in a placeholder, x to the first, or x. So we'll have x squared plus 0x minus 74, and that will be divided by x minus 8. How many times does x go into x squared? That's x number of times. So we're going to take that x and multiply it by x minus 8. X times x minus 8 is x squared minus 8x. And that's subtracted. X squared will cancel out, and 0x minus negative 8x is a positive 8x. And we're still subtracting 74. So now we're going to see how many times x goes into 8x. And that's positive 8. So we'll take that positive 8 and multiply it, and that'll give us 8x minus 64. And we're subtracting that. So 8x minus 8x is 0, and negative 74 minus negative 64 will be a negative 10. So our remainder is negative 10. And for our solution, we'll have x plus 8 minus, since the remainder is negative, 10 over x minus 8, what we divided by. X plus 8 minus 10 over x minus 8. And number 12, you can see I have p squared, p to the first, and p to the 0, which is simply 1. So I do not need to write in any placeholders. I'll take my 2p squared plus 7p minus 39 and divide that by 2p minus 7. How many times does 2p go into 2p squared? That's p times. So I'm going to take p and multiply that by 2p minus 7 and subtract that quantity from my first polynomial. So p times 2p minus 7 is 2p squared minus 7p. And when I subtract that, 2p squared will cancel out, and 7p minus a negative 7p is 14p. But I'm still subtracting that 39. So now I'm going to see how many times 2p goes into 14p, and that's a positive 7. So 7 will now get multiplied to 2p minus 7. 7 times 2p minus 7 is 14p minus 49. And that is subtracted. 14p minus 14p is 0. Negative 39 minus a negative 49 is a positive 10. So I have p plus 7 with a remainder of 10. So in my solution, I'll have p plus 7 plus, since our remainder is positive, 10, the value of our remainder, over what we divided by, 2p minus 7. So p plus 7 plus 10 divided by 2p minus 7 is my solution in number 12. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 13. However, before I do this answer, click that subscribe button and like this video. I have n cubed plus 7n squared plus 14n plus 3 divided by n plus 2. My first step is to see how many times n goes into n cubed, and that's n squared. So n squared will get multiplied to n plus 2. N squared times n plus 2 is n cubed plus 2n squared, and that is going to be subtracted. So n cubed minus n cubed is 0. 7n squared minus 2n squared is 5n squared, and I'm still bringing down these terms or adding them. So adding 14n and adding 3. Now I'm going to see how many times n goes into 5n squared. N goes into 5n squared, a positive 5n. So now I'm taking that 5n and multiplying it to n plus 2. So 5n times n plus 2 is 5n squared plus 10n. And when I subtract that, 14n minus 10n is 4n, and I'm still adding 3. Now I'm going to see how many times n goes into 4n, and that's a positive 4 times. So now I'll take that 4 and multiply it by n plus 2. 4 times n plus 2 is 4n plus 8. So when I subtract 4n minus 4n is 0, and 3 minus 8 is negative 5. So I have a remainder of negative 5. So my solution, n squared plus 5n plus 4 minus, since my remainder is negative, the value of that remainder 5 over what we divided by n plus 2. So n squared plus 5n plus 4 minus 5 over n plus 2. And you can see in number 13 that even though we started with the cubed, we still did our steps the same way. We looked at our first term, saw how many times that went into it, multiplied by the answer, and then subtracted. And then continued with that until we got to our constant. Now, if you have any questions, please leave a comment below, and I or one of your peers will respond as quickly as possible. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up on this video. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 14 through 20.